Thank you for the introduction, and thank you all for coming this morning. So my talk is about a tool we made to search for Dmirci Celsius attacks against a large class of block cipher. So I will begin my talk with a short introduction about Dmirci Celsius attacks. Then I will describe the algorithm we designed to search for such attacks. And finally, I will show you some applications. In particular, I will show you that we can reuse the components of our algorithm to build two other tools. One to search for basic meet-in-the-middle attacks, and another one to search for truncated impossible differential attacks. So let's begin. Dmirci Celsius attacks were introduced at FSE 8 years ago, by Dmirci and Celsius, to attack AES 192 and 256. Since then, their technique was improved a lot, and it's now one of the most powerful against various block ciphers. So, for instance, this technique leads to the best results against the three versions of AES, which is a byte-oriented SPN. It also leads to the best results against mkrypton and Prince, which are SPN with bit-oriented linear layers. Also against Twine, which is a nibble-oriented Festel network. And also against Camellia, it gives good results. So what is a Dmirci Celsius attack? So the idea is to follow the encryption of a collection of messages through many rounds. Here is an example with four AES rounds. So for a collection of plain text such that one byte is active while the other ones are constant, the sequence of values of the circled byte depends on only 25 bytes, and so there are only 2 to the 200 possible sequences. So we can use this property to, for instance, mount an attack against seven rounds. This is done by first computing all the possible sequences from the previous property and store them in a hash table. And then in an online phase, we first have to identify the collection of plain text by propagating differences to the plain text. And then we have to partially decrypt the collection of the corresponding collection of ciphertext and compute the sequence and check if it belongs to the table. So that's the idea of Dmirci Celsius attack. There are already two tools to help in finding such attacks. The first one was designed by Pierre-Alain and I and presented at FSE 13. So it is dedicated to AES, and the shape of all possible attacks is hard-coded. Okay. So basically, we just use the tool to compute the complexity of all attacks in order to find the best one. There were approximately 2 to the 16 attacks, and that's why we used such an approach. The same year, Lin et al. Proposed another tool to find to help in the search of Dmirci Celsius attack. So their tool is dedicated to word-oriented block cipher, so it's much more generic, but it only focuses on the distinguisher part and does not take into account the key schedule relations in the block cipher. So cryptanalysts still have a lot of work to do. So what we wanted to do with Pierre-Alain was to build a tool finding the best Dimirci Celsius attacks on almost any block cipher. So the tool takes as input a system of equations describing the block cipher, together with a categorization of variables involved in the system of equations. We impose that equations have this type, where the S-boxes are seen as black boxes, except for the binary operations and all that we handle a bit differently. We also impose some natural conditions on the system of equation. That means from the plain text and the key, from the knowledge of the plain text and the key, we can compute all the intermediate state variables and the ciphertext, and of course the same from the ciphertext and the key. And that all the key variables can be computed from a master key. Okay, so natural condition for a block cipher. So our first, first we noticed that a Dimirci Celsuc attack is always constructed from a truncated difference propagated in both ways with probability one. So here, and a basic meet in the middle attack. Then the corresponding Dimirci and Celsuc attack is here. So the distinguisher part, the active variable of the distinguisher part are exactly the intersection between the red variables here and the green variables here. While the online phase of the attack you need to guess the blue variable here and the green the yellow variables. Okay, so to exhaust all Dimirci and Celsuc attacks, we just have to exhaust all such truncated characteristics and all such basic meet in the middle attacks. So we defined for each non-key variable y, four sets, FP, FC, TP, and TC, containing respectively the state variables required to propagate differences from the plain text to y, from the ciphertext to y, from y to the plain text, and from y to the ciphertext. To compute those sets, we just do some linear algebra on the system of equations given to the tool. So here an example on a toy cipher. So a Festel network. So on the left side, you can see an example of set TP. So what does that mean? If you know the variable which goes through the blue S boxes, then you can propagate the difference from the state variable with a star to the plain text. Okay? That's okay. And on the right side, you have an example of the set FP. So if you know the state variable that goes through the red S boxes, then you can propagate the differences from the plain text to the variable with a star. Okay, so you may remark that those sets are distinct. Actually, this is always the case for Festel network, but for most of SPN, as for instance on AES, both those sets are equal. Okay, as well as TC and FC. So to search for all the truncated characteristics and all the basic meet in the middle attacks, we use a guess and determine strategy on the on the set state variables. So you may note that both algorithms, so both update rules for the guess and determine strategies are very similar. And actually, if you take those update rules and switch T and P, you obtain those update rules. So for instance, for AES, searching for truncated characteristics is similar to searching for between the middle attacks. It's not similar, it's exactly the same. So I'll show you an example on how we perform the search. So first, there is an initialization where all state variables can pick all possible states. Then we pick at random one variable, and for instance, we guess that it belongs to TP. So it means that it will be an active variable, and its difference will be propagated with probability 1 to the plain text. So we apply the update rules and deduce many variables that will also be in the set TP. And then, instead of selecting at random the next variable we will guess, for which we will guess its state, we first look for a minimal equation involving the first variable we guessed and variables that may be constant or are constant. Okay? So if all those variables are constant, then the first variable we guessed would also be constant. So at least one of those variables should be non-constant, and we know that our first guess will be one of those variables. So we restrict the tree we have to exhaust. Okay, and for basic meet in the middle attack search, it's exactly the same, but instead of looking for minimal equations involving possibly constant variables, we look for minimal equation involving possibly non-used variable. So variables that will be involved in the meet in the middle. Okay. There is a last component in our algorithm. Because we want to make an attack finder, we need to be able to compute the complexity of the attacks in order to find the best one. And doing so requires to compute how many values some set of variables can assume. So to do that, we use the same approach we used for our previous tool. Basically, we have an algorithm that takes as input a system of equations E in variables X and a subset Y. And we want basically to know how many values can assume the variables of y. And the algorithm outputs a subset z containing y, and such that its number of solution of possible values according to e is minimal. So in practice, we used this algorithm on the key schedule only, and it's very fast for nearly a linear system of equation E. So for instance, for the key schedule of AES, it's very fast, and for linear key schedule, it's very, very fast. And it handles some sophisticated techniques as the key bridging, for instance. The key bridging is a key bridging is a relation between rune keys in of the first rounds and rune keys of the last rounds. Okay. So that's all the algorithms in our tool. So now let's see some applications. So we first applied it to the block cipher mCrypton. So mCrypton is an SPN with 4 4-bit S-boxes, and its linear layer is bit-oriented. Okay. So we select this block cipher because several researchers published results of Demercy-Cell SUC attacks against mCrypton. Okay. And as a result, our tool was able to find better attacks on two versions of this block cipher. So basically, we increased by one the number of rounds attacked. Okay. And there are 12 rounds on for mCrypton. And the results of Ao et al. Are Demercy-Cell SUC attacks. Okay. So for instance, on the 128-bit versions, we are able to attack one more round with approximately the same complexity. Okay. So it shows that that an automatic approach is very useful. So next application, the block cipher Zorro. So Zorro is a block cipher based on AES, but the S-box is applied only on the first row each round. Okay. So Zorro was already broken, but we wanted to study the resistance of this design against Demercy-Cell SUC attack because they lead to best results against AES, so it could be interesting to see how they work on design like Zorro. So we studied 11 variants of Zorro. We choose to try different positions for the byte on which we applied the S boxes, but we impose that at least one S box is applied per column and per diagonal because of the shift rows and the mixed column operations. So that's the 11 variants we studied with our tool, and as a result, we found that the resistance to Demercy-Cell SUC attacks only depends on the number of S-box free rows. Okay. And if there is only one S-box free row, then 20 rounds are required to be fully secure against such attacks. While if there are two or three S-box free rows, then 25 rounds are fully secure, are required to be fully secure. And so Zorro is here, so there are three S-box free rows. And the original version of Zorro has only 24 rounds. So we have an attack against the full Zorro, but it is not as efficient as the best attack on Zorro. Okay, so that's another application that shows how useful can be our tool to designer when designing a new block cipher to select between two designs. One of the components of our algorithm is the search of basic meet-in-the-middle attacks, so we can use this search on itself. And for instance, we applied it to the block cipher ID, which is a 64-bit block cipher that uses XOR, modular addition and multiplications over a finite field. As a result, we automatically rediscovered the six-round meet-in-the-middle attacks of Biham et al. And in particular, we also retrieved the Kiles-Biryukov-Demirci relation, which is an equation involving some plaintext, intermediate state, and ciphertext variables, which is central in best known attack against ID and was discovered only 15 years after ID was introduced. So again, it shows how useful our tool can be. We can also reuse the truncated characteristic search to build a tool searching for impossible differential attacks. So basically, such kind of attack are composed of two differences propagated in both ways with probability one, such that the transition from the first one to the second one is impossible. Okay, so we just used our search of truncated characteristics and combine two of them and check if there are some contradiction. So we applied this tool to the block cipher XT, which is an ARX block cipher. So you see involving some rotation and modular addition. Okay. We were not able to search for impossible, for truncated impossible differential attacks, but we were able to search for only truncated impossible characteristics, and as a result, we automatically retrieved the longest one on XT in a few minutes. Okay. We also applied it to the block cipher Simon, so we found attacks on one more round for those three versions of Simon. So the tool did not find any longer impossible transition, but it found which one to use to take advantage of the key schedule equations. In particular, we found some key bridging technique involving some relation involving the first round keys and the four last ones. Okay, so the tool have some limitations, so some complex key schedule are hard to handle, and also when you fully describe modular addition to fit the type of equations we expect, there are too many variables and the search takes a lot of time, sometimes many days or even more. There is also an issue with the way in the way we compute the complexity of truncated impossible differential attacks. So basically, our tool outputs all the parameters needed by the formula of Bura et al. But sometimes this formula is too optimistic, and the real complexity of the attack can be a bit higher than what is given by the formula. Okay, so in this paper we present a collection of automatic tools that find attacks. So I insist on the word attacks. You just have nothing to do. Okay, the tool will find the attacks. You just have to understand the attacks and to write a paper. So it look for Demirci-Celsuc attacks, basic meet-in-the-middle attacks, and impossible differential attacks, and the code source is publicly available. Thank you for your attention.